Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once again to House and Home. We are your hosts. I'm, of course, Godfrey.
And I'm Theresa.
And we obviously have an amazing show for you lined up this evening, starting off with an awesome recipe from Chef Jack, who's making for us a homemade pizza.
Yummy.
That sounds delicious. But then right after that, we go shopping with Brian Bell as Leon walks us through their amazing Mother's Day catalog and something
and
new and exciting.
And they also have this Be Mom's Favorite Competition.
Yes, something exciting called the Be Mom's Favorite Competition, which we'll touch on later on. But then right after that, Theresa, remind me, what do we have?
We have more DIYs that's going to be on fashion and beauty with also trends, giving you a very special edition on Mother's Day.
Yes. Then right after that, we have Lisa, who's helping me out to make some DIY pet life hacks. And then I'll be showing you some interesting life hacks to help you keep cool in this hot and dry Moresby weather. So I guess without further ado, but actually before we go, Theresa, have you ever had any homemade pizza before?
Yep, I've actually tried that. Well, I used corned beef and a couple of vegetables and yeah, they're just flame flour and all that, but I would really love to try the one Jack is preparing.
That sounds actually pretty easy to make. That's pretty cool.
What about you? Have you tried one?
Well, I actually have tried homemade pizza a while ago.
And what's your favorite flavor?
Oh, my favorite pizza flavor. It comes and goes. I started off as a meat lovers, but then it went to Hawaiian. But then now I have a really big thing for popcorn chicken pizza. I think that's really amazing. Yeah, it's just basically chicken nuggets on top of pizza, and I think that is the most amazing invention in the entire world.
Chicken nuggets
on pizza. That just blew my mind, and it tastes amazing. It's so incredible. But anyway, enough about popcorn chicken pizza. Let's take a look at this amazing homemade pizza that Chef Jack has prepared for us.
Enjoy.
Hello and good night, Papua New Guinea, and welcome to Cooking with Jack. Tonight, I'm going to show you everyone's favorite food and how to make it, and that's homemade pizza. For this homemade pizza, you will need for the dough, a tablespoon of baking powder, a teaspoon of salt, 60 grams of butter, 290 grams of plain flour, an extra cup of flour for dusting and kneading, and 1 cup of milk. For the topping, we have 1.5 cup of mozzarella cheese, 150 grams of tomato paste, bacon strips, mild pepperoni, and some red, yellow, green capsicum, onions, and pineapple chunks. Before we start, we need a nice flat round pizza tray, or you can use a square one if you want your pizza to be square. It's all up to you. For our dough, we need 290 grams of flour, 1 tablespoon of baking powder, 1 teaspoon of salt, 60 grams of butter. You can just use your fingers. Make sure the butter is at room temperature, and 1 cup of milk. And now it's ready for mixing. We have a nice mixer here, do all the job for us. Put it at medium speed and let the mixer do the mixing itself. But thanks to the mixer, it gets into all the hard work. Instead of using a wooden spoon and a bowl, the mixer is going to do everything for us. This should take at least 3 to 5 minutes for the mixer to bring our dough together. The mixer is on medium speed, so all the ingredients can mix well together. So our dough is done. Before we remove the dough from the mixing bowl, make sure to dust the bench so the dough doesn't stick to the bench because it's still sticky. That's how the dough should look like. And now we're gonna start kneading our dough. When kneading the dough, make sure to pull from the outside back into the middle and then you start filling the wetness of the dough, and then you keep adding more flour until it gets dry. I mean, not that dry. Just keep adding more flour until you feel the dough is dry. So you can see I'm just pulling from the outside and folding it in the middle and then adding more flour. And this is what you want our dough to look like. This is the form you want it to be. So now we're gonna get a rolling pin and roll it out. Make sure to just lightly dust your rolling pin so it doesn't stick to the rolling pin. So when using a rolling pin to roll your pizza dough, make sure to roll from the middle and push out towards the sides. And that way you get a nice even circle, a nice flat pizza dough. When rolling out your pizza dough, make sure to not roll it too thin. Roll it at least about a centimeter thick. And when it cooks in the oven, it rises to probably about 2 centimeters and it's nice and fluffy. So don't get carried away and roll it all over the place. Take out your pizza tray and compare the size to the dough and see. So I think we have the exact size we want. So before we start topping our pizza, do some cleaning up first. And we're done cleaning up. And you can see now our pizza is on our pizza tray. I just put it into the nice shape of, around the sides. It's time to put our toppings on our pizza. Before we start with everything, I'll just have to chop up some bacon. Now, if you see all these ingredients here, you don't necessarily need to put everything you see here. But the most main two ingredients that you need for making pizza are the tomato sauce and the cheese. You can either make seafood pizza, chicken pizza, or meat pizza. It's all up to you. Bacon is cut up. So now let's start topping our pizza. So the first step you do for a pizza, you put the sauce first. Get a nice teaspoon, put it in the middle. When putting the sauce, don't put too much. Just put enough to cover the top of the pizza base. So use the back of the spoon. Just gently paint the top of your pizza base. Put some around here. And that's it, I'm done with my pizza sauce. As you can see, I put it all the way around. I just put this away. And now I want to start with my cheese. With a generous amount of cheese. It is our mozzarella cheese. It's the perfect cheese for making pizza. Don't put too much, just put a bit. And then now I go on to our capsicums. Let's start with the green first because it's already red there. Make sure to evenly spread all the way around. If you go to some pizza shops, they tend to only put all the toppings in the middle. And when it comes to the edge of the base, it's just like the crust there. So try to put it all the way around, make it even. So you can see the variety of colors I have here with my capsicum, that I like making my pizza look colorful, and colorful looks delicious. I mean, tasting is actually delicious too. Just keep putting some more around here. Make sure the edges are nicely filled. Spread them evenly. Let's go with some onions. Spread them around. Just not in one area of the pizza. And now, let's put our bacon. You don't necessarily need to use bacon. You can use pork luncheon or ham or whatever topping you prefer to put on, or meat you prefer to put on your pizza. Just put a generous amount. You see, I cut mine. That's how I like my cut into nice big pieces. bake it on a mixer, spread it evenly at the sides. Normally when people bite the pizza, they bite from the part, the sharp part where it's cut. But once you, this pizza comes out of the oven, you don't want to bite around the edges. Now I want to add some more cheese on top. You don't necessarily need to put more cheese on top. You already have cheese there, but to your own liking, or if you want more cheese, it's all up to you. It also acts as another layer on top of the pizza. So what I want to do now, I put some more cheese on top, and then I want to add the pineapple. So when you first bite your pizza, you'll taste a nice pineapple first. So you have that nice sweetness from the pineapple and the little spicy taste from the capsicums and stuff. And now, this pepperoni is actually the signature look for the pizza. I'll just put them, place them around the edges first. And that should be enough pepperoni for our pizza. And our topping for our pizza is done. As you can see, I've put a lot of cheese, a lot of bacon, a lot of pepperoni. That's the way I want my pizza to be. So you have your own choice. If you want to have your pizza like this, if you want to put lots of bacon, lots of pepperoni, lots of cheese, it's all up to you. It's time for it to go to the oven. Now, the oven has been preheated for 250 degrees and it's going to be in there for 12 to 15 minutes. So it's been 13 minutes. Let's check your oven and see if our pizza is ready. Our pizza is done. And that's my homemade pizza. Look at how crispy the pepperoni is. Look at how all the cheese is melted. We have hidden underneath the cheese, the bacon, the pineapple, the onions, and the capsicum. I hope you learned a thing or two tonight. So now you can go out and make your own pizza just the way you like it. Thanks for watching and see you next time on Cooking with Jack.
Okay, that was really amazingly simple. I'm definitely gonna try that at home. Who knew that you can make pizza just like that? I'm blown away. Like, I'm gonna make my own popcorn chicken pizza.
I can't wait to try the one that you're preparing.
It's amazing, yeah. And maybe I'll bring it to work sometime and I'll give it to you guys. That'd be pretty fun. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna take a really short break right now. Stick around though, because when we come back, we've got more Mother's Day specials at Brand Bell.
Welcome back to the show, everyone. Now, Brand Bell keeps amazing its valued customers. Now, they still have this Mother's Day special going on. Mm-hmm. Gofferman, what are they covering this week?
Well, yes, they will be actually talking about more of their Mother's Day specials, but they'll actually be also talking about something new and exciting called the Be Mom's Favorite Competition, which is obviously a competition that you can enter to get some awesome stuff from Brian Bell. But enough from us. Let's take a look at what Leon from Brian Bell has to say about it.
Welcome to another Shopping with Brian Bell. I'm Leon Gowie, your host, and this is the show that gives you some great insight to the products that live on our showroom floor. Mother's Day is just 4 days away, and are you prepared for it, or have you got a gift for your mom? If not, there's no need to panic. All you have to do is come into Brian Bell, pick up one of our gift guides, and you'll see some great products in there that I'm sure your mom would love. So in this segment, I'll show you just what you can pick up for mom this Mother's Day. Let's go and take a look.
These gift guides that you can now get We'll help you select a great gift for your mom. So if you don't have the time to walk around in the shop, then all you have to do is pick up one of these gift guides and see the range of Mother's Day gift ideas that you can pick up for your mom.
Now the first product that I want to show you that's great for mums this Mother's Day is a combo from a brand that's new to Brian Bell called Haus. This is our steam iron and ironing board. This is a great combination that you can pick up from Brian Bell that I'm sure all mums would love. Now, this is, like I said, from a great brand that gives you quality products at an affordable price.
The Haus ironing board has steady legs on all adjustable lengths and also provides a good work surface to press out all the creases in your ironing. Forget about breaking your back and pressing your clothes off the bed or floor. This is a great and affordable solution for you. The iron is both steam and dry iron and also boasts an auto switch off function. Many accidents can be caused with the heat that irons produce, especially when you have kids around you while you're ironing. With this auto-off function, that will be a thing of the past.
Now the next Haus combo, which is perfect to give mum this Mother's Day, is this three-piece combo from Haus. We have a coffee maker, a jug, an electric jug, and a two-slice toaster. Now this is perfect to get now so you can make mum her breakfast in bed this coming Mother's Day. Not only do these products look good, but they're fully functional and perform really, really well. So you should get it now so you can enjoy your breakfast with mum this Mother's Day.
The 1.5 liter in the coffee maker gives ample quantity for mum's morning coffee to get her started on all her motherly duties. There is also enough to go around for dad to have his mug of coffee in the morning. The two-slice toaster has features like warm and defrost function, great to defrost or heat up your cold toast. Plus, it has different levels of toasting for your preference. You and I both know that toast in the morning is a great way to start your day. And this jug with its 1.7 liter capacity has enough to make tea for everyone so you can enjoy your evenings better.
Now, if you're worried about missing out on shopping because you have a busy schedule and need to work during the day, then fear not. Come into our Brian Bell Vision City. They're open from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. and you can find the same great products at our Gordon's Home Center or our plaza at Boroko, there at Vision City. So go there and shop for your mum this Mother's Day. Also, our Be Mum's Favorite competition is up and running. Now you have the chance to win weekly a 500 kina gift voucher or at the grand draw prize after the competition, a 2000 kina gift voucher. All you have to do is simply come in and shop with Brian Bell and you just might win something extra for mum this Mother's Day. Now imagine all the wonderful things you could get with a 500 kina or even that massive 2000 kina gift voucher. Come on in and shop now with any Brian Bell Home Center and you just might win something extra for mum.
Now you must note that this is not just limited to Brian Bell Home Centers in Port Moresby. This is extended to all 8 home centers around the country. Kokopo, Lay, Medang, Goroka, Mount Hagen, Gordon's Boroko, and Vision City. No matter where you are in the country, shop with Brian Bell and you can win.
So, how do you enter? Well, it's simple. All you have to do is spend 50 kina or more at any Brian Bell home center. Then you pick up one of these entry forms. Simply fill in your details on the entry form and drop it into the draw box.
And as if that's not enough, we have a store grand prize which will be drawn at the end of the competition. This is a 2000 kina gift voucher from Brian Bell to be spent at any of our home centers. There will be one winner each from all home centers around the country. This is a great way to show your mother you appreciate her this Mother's Day. Shop with Brian Bell now and win.
So the more you spend, the greater your chances are of winning. If you spend 50 kina, you get one entry form. If you spend 100 kina, you get two entry forms. If you spend 500 kina, you get a mammoth 10 entry forms. You get it right. The more you spend, the greater your chances are of winning something extra for mum this Mother's Day, being a 500 kina gift voucher or a 2000 kina gift voucher. So shop now at Brian Bell. You just might win something extra. Well, folks, we've come to the end of this segment. I know you've seen there's some great combos that you can pick up for mum this Mother's Day from a great brand that you can find here at Brian Bell, and it's Brian Bell's very own Haus brand. We have the coffee maker, the jug, and the two-slice toaster, plus we have the iron and the ironing board from Haus. So come on in and check it out for yourself and see what you can get for mum this Mother's Day. Also, pick up one of those gift guides. It's a great insight into the products here, so if you don't have the time, you can check the gift guides and pick out something for mum, then simply come into the shop and buy it. You could also win with our Be Mum's Favorite competition, either the 500 kina or the massive 2000 kina gift voucher. All the great stuff that you can pick up as extras for mum this Mother's Day simply by shopping here at Brian Bell. And always remember, quality products, great services, and great value. That's Brian Bell. I'd like to wish my mom a very happy Mother's Day. I love you. Thank you for always being there for me. And to all the mothers around here in Brian Bell and also in Papua New Guinea, a very happy Mother's Day on behalf of Brian Bell to all of you. Come on in and shop with Brian Bell and experience a great way of shopping. Until next time, goodbye and God bless.
Thank you so much, Leon, for those amazing specials and a more in-depth preview of the Be Mom's Favorite competition. That sounds pretty interesting, eh, Teresa? So, Teresa, do you have anything special planned for Mother's Day?
Oh, yeah, we just, like, as usual, we're just going to prepare lunch at home and probably just breakfast and then lunch and dinner, that's it.
That's pretty cool, though,
Something good for Mom.
All right, nice. Well, anyway, folks, we're going to take a really short break right now. But stick around, because when we come back, we have Teresa with more DIYs.
Welcome back, everyone. Now for fashion and beauty this week, I have a special DIY to show you all. That's going to be the cufflace jeans. Godfreyman, have you ever come across a clothing called cufflace jeans? Have you?
Cufflace jeans? I probably have, but the name doesn't ring a bell. What are cufflace jeans? I'm very confused.
Actually, you're going to just be applying laces on jeans. Like, you're just going to fold them up and then apply the laces and that's it.
Wow, that sounds still very confusing, but I'm sure that I'll learn from Teresa's next DIY. So I guess without further ado, let's take a look at how to make some calf lace jeans.
Hi everyone, and welcome to another fantastic edition of Fashion and Beauty with Haus and Home. I am so glad you could join me. Now today I will be showing you how to make some cufflace jeans. That is, we're spicing our old pair of jeans. If you're thinking of throwing them away, please do not do that just yet, because I have some awesome tips to show you. So let's get started. So for the props, you will need an old pair of jeans. Your final product is gonna look something like this, like I did. So I'm just gonna put this aside and work on the other one, a plain one, so that I can show you how to apply the lace. The next prop is your lace. You're gonna need some lace, some pins, a pair of scissors, tape measure, some glue sticks, and a glue gun. So for the glue sticks and the glue gun, you can find them at the stationery shops. For the lace, pins, and the pair of scissors plus the tape measure, you can find them at fabric shops, just anywhere, retail stores. So let's get started. What you want to do first is to apply the glue gun. This is how you place your glue stick into the glue gun. Something like this, and push right in. Yep, and switch on the power. So viewers, if you have young kids at home and you're trying to teach them how to do something like this, not like very young children, but if you want to teach them how to use a glue gun, you have to be very careful because it gets really hot. But I chose glue gun because the glue gets dried up quickly and it's like strong. Take your glue gun with the glue stick already added and start applying the glue. Apply glue on both sides. Always remember that glue sticks do melt quickly and they dry up in no time and they become so hot, so a little supervision will be needed when young ones are planning to try this out. So the next step we're doing is to apply the laces. This is my favorite part. I love this part. Let's fold it back. When applying the lace, this is the part where the old pair of jeans starts to look attractive. What you do next is to gently apply the glue and add your lace. Like I said earlier, glue gets really hot, so be careful.
first time I tried the DIY, I thought I did an awesome job and I was so proud of myself. That's the feeling you get when you try something new and it looks good at the end. Keep applying and pressing the lace against. Always remember that the glue gets dry, so apply glue and lace at the same time. So we're done with the first side of this pair of jeans, and I'm just gonna turn this and work on the other side. Like I said earlier on, this is a very simple DIY. All you need is your glue and your laces. Apply something like this and wrap around. All around. All right, as you can see, I'm done with the both sides. The last thing I'm gonna do is to work on the pockets, the back pockets.
Step 3, applying lace on the back pockets. Place the lace on the back pocket and cut where you need to, and then apply the glue. Now this is just an additional idea if you really want to be more creative. It just adds more beauty to the old pair of jeans already looking amazing.
And there you have it. This is how it's gonna look like at the back of your pair of jeans. Look at this, it's so beautiful. Now, all you need is your pair of jeans and some lace, plus your glue sticks and your glue gun. But if you want to be a lot more sure about the measurements, you can always need your tape measure. So all of this you can find at the fabric shops and the stationery department stores everywhere in the city. So yep, I'm so excited to show you all of this, and I hope you've learned a thing or two. Please continue to tune in to House and Home's Fashion and Beauty, because I'll be always here to show you fashion DIYs. Until next time, it's goodbye.
Also, those are calf lace jeans. Those are pretty interesting. I noticed that you didn't actually sew. You were just using a glue gun. That's pretty helpful for like people who are afraid of needles and thread like I am. Yeah. So
you can easily try that. It's just folding up the lace and folding up the jeans and then applying the lace, and that's it, using a glue gun. It's a no-sew DIY, viewers.
Oh, that's pretty cool. Style has never been so easy. Anyway, we're going to take a really short break right now, but when we come back, we've got some more Mother's Day specials from Trends. And welcome back to House and Home, ladies and gentlemen. So next up on the show, we're actually going over to Trends to look at their Mother's Day specials to see all the cool things that they can do for your mom.
Trends have amazing spa and salon packages for Mother's Day, so do drop by and check them out. You're gonna be relaxed, I promise you that. So let's just take a look at what they have for us. Hello everyone, and welcome to a special edition on Mother's Day specials brought to you by the Trends Beauty International. Now with Mother's Day fast approaching, it's up to every son and daughter, husband or partner out there to show mom our appreciation. Thanks to people like Trends, this has become so much easier. Trends have amazing spa and salon packages on specials aimed at making mom look and feel beautiful.
At the Spa Pua, we have just the package for mom. A 90-day spa treatment. Check in spas for details on our Be Pampered package. Promo ends on the 31st of May. So moms, come on down to indulge yourself with the best hair, skin and massage treatment at Trans Beauty International, with professionals who know how to extract stress right from your bones.
I could wrap you in your favorite clothes and kiss your face just so you know that I'm the one who has got your back. Now turn around, don't be sad.
Start off your relaxation with a deep body massage. Followed by a relaxing facial that will leave you rejuvenated. And finally, undergo a cleansing foot bath whilst your fingernails get manicured. Perfect for the hardworking mom you know and love.
As you can see, Trans Beauty International has just the spoils you need for mom on Mother's Day and every other day with the products that are suited for lasting skincare, beautification, and wellness.
Purchase any Mother's Day package now showing on your screens at the salon and spa here at our Trans Beauty and Wellness branch. Your receipt will contain your address and phone number. Drop it in the entry box provided at our reception. You could be the winner of a luxury night away from home at La Mana Hotel, enjoying the Mediterranean buffet for lunch and other amenities while mom gets pampered. Winners will be drawn on Friday, 11th of May, and notified via phone call to check in on Saturday, the 12th.
Here at the salon, get mom a new hairdo with the specials we have for braiding, perm, texturizing, coloring, and more. Check in salon for more details. Promo lasts for the whole month of May. For those busy shoppers on the go, stop by at the Palmer's booth to grab a hamper filled with a variety of products suited for mom's body care every day.
That's all for this week, folks. For more on Trans Beauty International, keep watching House and Home. Oh, thank you, thank you.
Oh, that looks amazing and very relaxing too.
I love the all the spa stuff.
I've actually never been to a spa.
It's such a place where, like, when you just walk in, you just feel so relaxed, and the scent, everything about it is just so relaxing.
I guess that'll be no doubt quite helpful to all the mothers out there who are probably in need of some stress relieving. Yes.
I'm sure they do.
Yes. Anyway, we're going to take another short break right now, but after the break, when we come back, we've got some pet DIYs.
Welcome back to the show, everyone. This is House and Home. Like I always say, if you just tuned in, thank you so much for your company. Now, this week's Pet Hacks, we have Godfreyman and Lisa showing us some of the tips and tricks. Godfreyman, can you name some tricks that you're going to be showing on that?
Oh, I can talk about this really cute one that we did. It was basically, we gave a dog a sweater and it was so adorable. Oh. And you make the sweater out of actually like an old sweater that you had. So I thought that was quite cute. And it's the one that's on my mind right now. I mean, I wish I had a pet that had a sweater. That's just, I think that's just really, really cute.
Do you have one at home?
No, my dog ran away from me, but that's okay, and my cat, but that's okay. Anyway, but put that all aside, let's take a look at some of these awesome DIY pet care hacks that'll be helpful to your pet.
Enjoy.
Hey everybody, and welcome to another installment of Pet Care. This week on the show, we'll be making for you some pet DIYs with some help from Lisa in the studio. Now, when it gets too cold, this might not be the best thing for your furry little friend. So here's how you can make a really cute sweater just for your pup.
The props you will need: a pair of scissors, an old sweater, preferably one that doesn't fit you well. Spread out the sweater. Sweater's one-sided hand in half, then fold it in half. Now cut a square shape in the middle of the edge of the sweater. And there you have it, a simple DIY to keep your cat warm if the weather gets too cold. Tired of refilling your pet's water bowl? Well, why not make this cute little contraption to make sure that your pet stays well hydrated? Let's see how it's done. For this DIY, the materials you will need are some strong tape, your pet's water bowl, plastic container. First, fill the plastic container with water and also your pet's water bottle. Using the tape, tape the open end of the container before releasing the water from the container into the bowl. Then, tape the water bowl onto a post under your house, or you can use a stand, as long as it's suitable to hold the container. Once that's done, remove the lid or the closing of the container and let the water flow out. The wording quite effectively explains it all. These are water bowls that fill up on their own when their water levels get too low. If you're a busy parent that works for the good part of the day, you might want to make sure that your dog has a steady supply of fresh water at all times. And the self-refilling dog water bowl may be the ultimate solution for you. This allows a steady source of water available on demand exclusively for your dog. Most self-refilling dog water bowls work on the principle of gravity with convenient flow control valve, which fills the bowl up as your pet drinks, always ensuring a supply of fresh water.
Now, if you don't have access to a fur roller, you can make one easily out of just a rubber glove and some water. Here's how.
This last DIY is easy. You'll just need a rubber glove and some water. Simply wet your gloves with water and gently rub over your pet's body to remove any unwanted fur. As you can see, the fur on the glove, which I removed from the cat using the water rubber glove.
so this fur doesn't get onto your furniture or on your body whenever the pet is around you.
Alrighty folks, well that just about wraps up our pet DIY life hacks for this week. For more life hacks, stay tuned to House and Home. See y'all later.
Viewers, those are some of the tips and tricks that you can try out for your pets, for all you pet lovers out there.
It was indeed very fun just making all those cute little things for the pets. I really enjoyed that, and I like working with the animals. They're so cute. Anyway, we're going to take a really short break right now. When we come back, though, I have more life hacks just for you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another installment of Life Hacks. So, as you can see, it's quite a hot day here in Moresby. So, this week on Life Hacks, I'm going to be showing you all some tips on how to keep cool in this dry Moresby heat. So if you're looking for a quick fix and just to cool yourself down when it gets too hot, all you need is a sponge, some rubbing alcohol, and a Ziploc bag. Now this next hack is gonna be a little weird one, so bear with me. If you wanna keep your sheets really, really cold, just put them in the refrigerator for a bit. Then when you bring them out, they'll be freezing by the time you wrap yourself in them. So this next hack is for when you're in a room that's really, really hot, but it doesn't have an air conditioner or the fan's really slow. And all you need is an old plastic bottle, or a couple might I add, and a fridge. Now this next hack is really helpful for watering your garden and keeping you cool at the same time. All you need is a large plastic bottle, a hose, and some tape. Here's how it's done. Now this next hack is pretty useful for when you want to cool down your drinks just like that. And all you need is a little bit of water and some paper tissue. so refreshing. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you learned something about how to keep yourself cool in the dry Moresby weather. For more life hacks, keep watching House and Home. So nice and cool.
I'm just gonna have to talk about the sprinklers. Like, they were so fun. There was, like I said, the unpredictable weather. You can do such things.
And it was super easy to make. I mean, all you need is just the plastic bottle, a hose, some tape, and just like a knife to just cut the little holes in it.
I really enjoyed that part.
Yeah, that was really easy. And like a bunch of the other hacks are also amazingly incredible. And all you need is pretty much just a fridge and some water. And it just takes a little bit of time and pretty much you'll be cooling down in no time.
That you can try at home. Anyways, unfortunately, we've come to the end of our show. We hope you've enjoyed watching this. Like, we've really enjoyed your company as well.
Yes, thank you so much for that. And if there's anything you want to ask us about the show, if there's anything you're curious about on this episode or any of the other episodes that we've had on the station, just please feel free to email us, Facebook us, whatever. Just get in contact with us if you want to ask us questions, and we'll get back to you as soon as possible.
That's right. On behalf of the entire House and Home team, pleasant viewing. Good night.